Good day, everyone. I hope you are fine today. This is Teacher Amina Jamery Julkanain, and ahlan wa sahlan. Welcome to our madrasa class in Arabic language for week 7. Today, learners, I am going to share to you about the antonym. In Arabic words, al-kalimatu mutadaddatu. Again, in Arabic, al-kalimatu mutadaddatu. And I want you to listen very carefully and try to define antonyms. I know you are now all ready to listen, so let us begin. Before we proceed, make sure you are ready and prepared with your materials needed for today's lesson, such as ballpen and capsule. And most especially, pay attention and focus to our discussion. Okay, take a look at the picture. What have you observed? Okay, the size of an apple. All right. What about the size of an apple? Okay, it is big and small. Okay, what do you call that words? All right, it is an antonyms. Now, we shall define the antonyms, or in Arabic word, kalimatul mutadad. Okay, that is kalimatul or kalimatu al-kalimatu mutadaddatu. Okay. Now, let's define antonyms. What is antonyms? Okay. These are words that have opposite meanings. So, in Arabic, ما هي الكلمات المتضاد؟ ما هي الكلمات المتضاد؟ هي كلمة معاكسة لمعنى آخر. Okay. I repeat. هي كلمة معاكسة لمعنى آخر. All right. Okay, I have here an example. Okay. Qaribun, ba'idun. Qaribun, children, meaning it is near. So what is the opposite of near? Of course, it is far. In Arabic, far is ba'idun. Okay. Near, qaribun, far, ba'idun. So the opposite of qarib is ba'id. Okay, another example, like jadidun, qadimun. Jadid means new. Qadim means old. So the opposite of new is old. Like jadid, new, qadim, old. Okay, another example, yani misal, kabirun. Okay, kabirun, the opposite of kabir is sagirun. In English, big, and the opposite of big is small. Alright, let's go to other example. Tawilun. The opposite of tawilun is qasirun. In English, tawil, tall. Qasir, short. Yay! Another example is kathirun. Kathirun, many. Qalilun, few. Again, kathirun, many. Qalilun, few. So the opposite of many is few. The opposite of kathirun is qalil. All right. Now, I want you to answer the self-assessment question. ما هي الكلمة المتضادة؟ ما هي الكلمة المتضادة؟ Okay, what are antonyms? Again, what are antonyms? Okay, learners, your answer is أيوة هي كلمة معاكسة لمعنى آخر. أيوة ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. Or in English, these are words that have opposite meanings. Okay, and then for the question number two, give the opposite meaning. Okay, of the following words. Jadidun. Hey, so what is the opposite meaning for jadidun? Aywa is what? Qadimun. Nice. Again, what is the opposite for kabirun? The opposite word for kabirun. Right, it is sagirun. Very good. Okay, now another one is ba'idun. So what is the opposite word for ba'idun? Okay children, what is the opposite of words ba'idun? All right, is qaribun. Very good. Okay, let's practice what you have learned today by answering the following question. Okay, match the given words with its opposite and write the letter of the write the letter of the correct answer on the space provided for. Okay, number one. Tawilun. Okay, number one, tawilun. Okay, what is your answer? What letter? All right, letter A, it's qasirun. Okay, let's go to number two. Jadidun. Again, jadidun. Okay, your answer is letter B. All right. It's qadimun. Okay. Let's go to number 3. Qaribun. Again, qaribun. Okay, your answer is ba'idun, letter. All right, letter C. Next, we go to number 4. Okay, number 4 is kabirun. Kabirun. Okay, your answer is letter? All right, letter D. It is sagirun. It is sagirun. Okay, next we go to number 5. Number 5 is kathirun. Again, kathirun. Okay, so your answer is letter E, qalilun. Okay, learner, we're going to remember the following. Okay, I want you to remember this, learners. Okay, al-kalimatul mutadadda hiya kalimatun mu'akasatun lima'naha aw lima'na akhar. Again, al-kalimatul mutadadda hiya kalimatun mu'akasatun lima'na akhar. Or in English, these are words that have opposite meanings. Let's see how much you have learned today by answering the following question. Directions. Match column A with column B by connecting it. Okay, let me read the words. Kabirun, qaribun, qadimun, kathirun, wa qasirun. Again, in the column A, kabirun, qaribun, qadimun, kathirun, qasirun. Okay, now what is the match for kabirun? Okay, it's sagirun, right? You are correct. And then qaribun? Okay, ba'idun. Nice. How about qadimun? Okay, it's jadidun. Okay. Kathirun. Okay, the opposite for kathirun is qalilun. Okay, qasirun. Qasirun. Okay, the opposite is qawilun. Again, kabirun is big. The opposite of big is small, it is sagirun. Qaribun or near, the opposite of qarib is ba'id, far. So, now kathirun, the opposite of kathir is what? Qalil, aywa. So, kathir, many, in qalil, few. Okay, qadimun. So, what is the opposite for qadimun? Or old. So, the opposite for the old is jadid, new. And for the opposite of short or qasir is tall, tawil in Arabic. All right. Okay, give the antonyms of the following Arabic words. Okay. Now, qadim. Okay. Qadimun. Aywa. Jadidun. Qaribun. Kathirun. Qalilun. Okay. Okay, qadimun, the opposite is jadidun. And then the jadidun, the opposite is qadimun. And qaribun, the opposite is, what is the opposite of qaribun? Aywa, ba'idun. Very good. Now, the opposite meaning for, or the opposite word for kathirun. Kathirun. I mean, yeah, kabirun. I'm sorry, kabirun. So, what is the opposite for kabirun? Aywa, qasirun. Alright. Next. Qalilun. What is the opposite of qalilun? Aywa, qalilun is kathirun. Aywa. Good job, learners. I know you did well on this activity. I hope I was able to make a clear discussion of today's lesson, and I hope that you will learn something from the lesson that I discussed to you. And I hope the discussions after this lesson was clear and you have learned something new today. So to conclude our lesson for today, once again, this is teacher Amina Jamari Chilkanain. Barakallahu fikum wa jazakumullahu khairan. Shukran. Keep safe, everyone. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A blessed day to you, my beloved learners. How are you today? I hope you're doing well. Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban bikum. Welcome to Arabic Language
Grade 6, Week 7 and 8. This is Teacher Napisa H. Ainadi, your teacher for today. Before we start our lesson, make sure you are in a comfortable place. Get your capsulet, ball pen, paper, and notebook for you to jot down important matters during discussions. Children, listen carefully and attentively. Try to comprehend our lesson for today. Okay, children, are you ready? So let's begin. Our topic for today is about asifatu. Meaning of asifatu is adjective. For us to be guided in today's lesson, our objectives are: number one, give the meaning of adjective. Number two, identify the adjective in a sentence. To start with, let us first define asifatu or the adjective. Asifatu ta'ti ba'da al-ismi lituwaddihahu. وإذا كان الموصوف معرفة كانت الصفة معرفة. إذا كان الموصوف نكرة كانت الصفة نكرة. It means that the adjective comes after the noun to clarify or describes it. If the adjective is common noun, the word after it should also be common noun. If the adjective is proper noun, the word after it should also be proper noun. Okay, children, did you understand? Let's continue. Okay, let's read a paragraph using adjectives. The title of paragraph is Al-Kitabu, meaning the book. الكتاب المفيد صديق نافع والذي يقرأ الكتاب يعرف شيئا كثيرا من الحياة. The useful book is a valuable friend. Whoever reads a book knows many things in this life and does not get bored. الكتاب جليس لا يمل جليسا والكتاب وعاء مملوء علما وهو ناطق ينطق عن الأحياء ويتحدث عن الموتى. The book is a container that full of knowledge and wisdom. It tells the life of an individual and the story of his death. والقرآن الكريم خير الكتب أنزله الله لأهدي به الناس إلى الصراط المستقيم. And the Holy Quran is the best book that Allah sent to guide mankind. Okay, children, are you still with me? The adjective used in this paragraph are Al-Mufidu. It means useful. Next, Nafi'un. Valuable. Next adjective, Kathiran. Many. Another adjective used is Mamlu'un. Full. And the last adjective we got from the paragraph is Al-Mustaqim, guide. Now, children, let's answer this self-assessment question. Okay, what is adjective? Ma ma'na as-sifa? Okay, we will answer. The meaning of as-sifatu is as-sifatu ta'ti ba'da al-ismi lituwaddihahu. Wa idha kana al-mawsufu ma'rifatan kanat as-sifatu ma'rifatan. إذا كان الموصوف نكرة كانت الصفة نكرة. Meaning, the adjective comes after the noun to clarify or describe it. If the adjective is common noun, the word after it should also be common noun. But if the adjective is proper noun, the word after it should also be proper noun. Okay, let's practice what we have learned today. Directions. Tawjihun. Ba' khattan tahta sifati fil jumalil atiyati. Underline the adjective in the following sentences. Number one sentence. Hadihi khariqatun nafi'atun. Okay, where is the adjective in this sentence, children? Okay, let's answer. The answer is Nafi'atun. Okay, are you done? Number two. الرجل المسلم. Meaning, the man is Muslim. So where is the sifa in this sentence? Okay, the answer is المسلم. Number three. القميص الصفراء جديد. Meaning, the yellow shirt is new. Okay, where is the asifa in this sentence? Okay, The answer is asafra'u. Okay, class, did you get it? I hope so. Now, let's remember these key points. As-sifatu ta'ti ba'da al-ismi lituwaddihahu. Wa idha kana al-mawsufu ma'rifatan, kanat as-sifatu ma'rifatan. Idha kana al-mawsufu nakiratan, kanat as-sifatu nakiratan. Meaning, the adjective comes after the noun to clarify or describe it. If the adjective is common noun, the word after it should also be common noun. And if the adjective is proper noun, the word after it should also be proper noun. Okay, children. Clear? Now, let's see how much have you learned today. Answer the self or assessment. Directions. Taujihun. Ba' khaffan tahta sifati fil jumalil atiyati. Number one. Al-baytul kabiru jamilun. Again, al-baytul kabiru jamilun. It means that the big house is beautiful. Just underline the adjective. Number two, ash-shajaratu al-khadra'u kathiratu al-thimari. Again, ash-shajaratu al-khadra'u kathiratu al-thimari. Meaning, the green tree have many fruits. Number three, al-talibu az-zakiyu qad najaha fil imtihan. Meaning, the bright student passed the examination. Okay, number four. Al-mudarrisu al-mahiru sharaha ad-darsa. Again, al-mudarrisu al-mahiru sharaha ad-darsa. Meaning, the teacher or the expert teacher explained the lesson. And number five, al-tabibu as-satiru yu'aliju al-marda. Meaning, the expert doctor is giving medicine to the patient. Okay, children, that's all for today. It's time for me to say bye now. I hope that you understand well and learned something new. Keep on studying and reading ahead of time for you to comprehend well the lesson taught. Again, this is Teacher Napisa H. Ainadi saying, Wadaan, ilan liqa! Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A pleasant morning to my beloved pupils of grade 1. I am Teacher Jahara Ayla Ja'alam, your Islamic values teacher for today. Kayfa halukum ya atfal, mauno-uno na kamu mga anak murid. I hope you are fine today. So our topic for today is about lesson 4. I make myself pure and clean. Okay, hadi pa kita makapagtagna sin pangajian ta, suway kamu sadya dumungog marayaw. Lingkod kamu marayaw, salta kaon nyo in capslet nyo iban sin ballpen niyo. Hasupaya hikasulat nyo in mga kalalagihan, isulat. Okay, so for us to be guided, let me read the objectives of our lesson. Okay, number 1, recite the Shahadatain or the testimony of faith. Basaha in dua pagsaksi. Number 2, perform the proper steps of wudu or the ablution. Hinanga in aturan marayaw sin pag-air. And the third, recognize the importance of God Allah Ar-Razak, the everlasting sustainer in one's life. Lagguay in kabasaran sin Tuhan Allah, magdidihir riziki. Way katubtuban sin pagdihil niya riziki, hakabuhi sin hangkatao. So now let's proceed to understanding. So hukaban niyo yung capslet niyo. Aun kakitaan nyo rin doon, tutaod niya, anak murid. Ingan niya, Hisali, Hirafi, Iban, Yusuf. Okay, so let's listen to their conversation. Dungukun na to in pagsambung laong, sinto, mag-classmate.
Yusuf, our teacher told us to always wash hands with soap and clean water. Yusuf, nag-iyan in mastal daran papaghugasun in lima. Sin sabon iban tubig.
Yes, we wash our hands every time we perform sala. We do that 5 times a day. Hoon, maghugas kita niyo 5 na to sa kahaba magsambahayang.
That is wudu. We also do it before reading the Quran. Bihan in pagwudu, magwudu da isab sumamasa Quran. Okay, so amuyat to in pagsambung laong sinto mag classmate. So nangasubo, nagdihil sila idea. Yusuf, nagbaitain mastal niya, suway sila daran papaghukasun sin sabun iban sintuwig malano. Okay, damikyan, inagiisabi Yusuf. Na bihat to raisab apabila kita magsambahayang na maghukas da isab kita sin limata. So inhantang niya bang magsambahayang subay kita mag-air. Okay, iban bang magbasa isab Quran subay resab kita mag-air. Okay, so I keep myself pure and clean. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is delighted in me. So, daran ko paglanuan, iban, susihun in baran ko, supaya makuyag kako in Allahu Ta'ala. So, in Allahu Ta'ala, in kabayaan niya, katu subay kita, malano, masusi, iban sin, malano. So, baon sarapat, subay kita daran mag-ail, maghukas. Sin pamarananta hasupaya malayo kita nyo din ha mga sakit luba na sakit bihaon yan subay kita daran maghukas sin limata. Okay, so halianta kugdanan kita si mga COVID sakit yan makawa din ha mga uno din ha mga lumi amin sakit di pagkakitaan. So subay kita mag ayad. So, mari kita nyo pa self-assessment question number 1. Okay, what are the ways of keeping your body clean? So, unuin mga aturan hikalanu sinbaran.
Okay, so mataud pa din ha mga aturan, hikalano sinbaran. Uno naman, so bang nyo kaingatan? Okay, so marayaw. So hibay ta ko kaniyo, bang uno naman in mga aturan, hikalano sinbaran. So keeping our body clean, ikaisa, brushing our teeth twice a day. Subay ra kita magbrush sin ipon makaduhang kaadlaw. Okay, number two, taking a bath every day. Subay kita mamaygu adlaw-adlaw supaya kita malano. Number three, combing our hair with a clean comb. Manuglay sin suglay malano. Number four, clipping or trimming our nails shorts. Manuptup sin kuko. Bukon pasaran in kukutayan maghawa. Kasuran siya sin kakaw malumi mahinang tasakit. So, subay siya tuptupan. Ikalima, washing our hands before each meal. So, hugasan in lima hadi pa kumaon. Atawa before and after eating. Subay kita maghugas sin lima ta, hadi pa kita makakaon. Iban mang kita isab maubos na kumaon, subay resab kita humugasin lima ta. Supaya kita malano. Okay, so nakakakamu pangajian dito mga bata. Alhamdulillah. Okay, biyaon pangajiun ta in mga steps when performing wudu. Okay, dungog ka mo marayaw ini in aturan si pag-ambil wudu. Hasupaya kita makasambahayang, subay kita magwudu na amuna. Sabab in wudu, amu ini in hinang, hadi pa kita maka tindog sin sambahayang. Okay, hika isa, make niya or the intention to perform wudu. So, magniat bang tumagna na mag-ail. Okay, niyatun muna halom sin pangatayan mo in ikaw yaon mag-ail karna in ikaw sumambahayang. Okay, number two, recite Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Inhati niya, masa sin lapal Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Inhika to, wash your hands. Humugas sin 25 makatu. Ikaupat, rinse your mouth. Gumguman in simud makatu. Inikalima, sniff water then blow it out of your nose 3 times. Humanggit tubig hailong. Ampa mo hisunga makatupag balikan. So in hikal unum, wash your face. Hugasan in bayhu makatu. Okay, so in paghugas ta sin bayhu, amin bayhu tayan sa suku sin wala tiwuan sin buhok, doon haunahan, katan yan, part yan sin bayhu ta. So, hukasan in bayhu makatu. Ikapito, wash your arms up to your elbows. Humugas, inbukton tubtub pasiku. Makauna in tuu ang papalawa. Pagbalikan, makatu. Biarasin, hinang mo hakaibanan. Okay, hati niya, humugas kita sinbukton. Tub-tub pasiko, intuo, makatu, humuhugasan. Pag-ubos, ang paisa, matunisab ko palawa, makatu, isab, hugasan. Ikawalo, with your head, sumapusin u, makatu. Ikasyam, with your ears inside and out. Sapuhun, intay nga palawong pagwa, makatu. Okay. And then, ikahangpu, wash your feet. Hugasan in siki, tub-tub, pabuku-buku. Makauna in tuu, ampa, palawa, makatu. So, hugasan mo in siki mo, tuu, makatu, pag-ubos, ampa, isab ko, matun pa, Siki mo, dapit palawa, makatuy sabin pagkuhas mo. Tub-tub pa, buko-buko bang magkuhas. Hasupaya, lumano, maigin, lumi. Maubos man in mga hinangyat to, ang panakita, mang duaa. Okay, so isayang tayong dua lima tabiahan, mang duaa kita, i-recite ta, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashadu anna muhammadan rasulallah. So amu ini in lapal, basa hunta. So masa sin lapal, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashadu anna muhammadan rasulallah. So amu yato. Okay. So nakaingat na kamu bang biyariin in pag-air, muramurahan, mag-anad kamu, isuring kanyo in, nakapangadji haadlaw ini. So mari kita nyo pa self-assessment question. Question number 2. So pangasubo. So what are the steps in performing wudu? So uno in mga aturan sin pag-ambil air. Okay, so balikan ta ha, supaya katumtuman. So, magniat kita, bang tumagna na in mag-air. Ikarua, masa sinlapal bismillah. Inhika tu humugas, sin dua, lima makatu. Pag-ubos, gumguman in simod, makatu. Ubus humanggit sintubig hailong ampamuhisunga makatu pagbalikan. Inhika lima, inhika unum isa bukasan in bayhu makatu. Okay, hinika pito humugas sinbuktun tubtub pa siku. Okay, makauna into ampapalawa pagbalikan makatu. Ikawalo sumapusin o makatu. Inikasiyam, sapuhon intay nga palaumpakuwa makatu. Ubos inikahang po, hugasan insiki tubtub pabuku-buku, makauna intu ang papalawa makatu. Sarta bang naubos na in mga steps yato na ang panakita mag-recite sin babasahan halapal ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna muhammadar rasulallah. So dain hatu sampul na na in pag ayin or in pag ambil wudu ta. Okay, so mari kita niyo aun de indi pagnganan, let's practice. Okay, so counting caps let niyo iban sin ball pen niyo. Jawaban tayin mga pangasubo ini. So, basahon ko in directions, dungog kamu. And silker the picture that shows good habit. Hati niya, ligungiin patta amuin magpakita adat marayaw. Okay, so on din nun patta-patta ha-capslate niyo. Patta number 1, bata-bata. Eating while walking. Hati niya, magkaunsalta miyamanaw. Okay, so in ligungan mo, amin marayaw in habit. Marayaw in adat, ha? Magpakita sin pangadatan marayaw. Ikarua, washing the fruits before eating it. Ugasan in bungang kahoy nasung kumaon. Atin niya bang ang mga bungang kahoy, biya na sin mga mangga, apple, ununonap. Ugasan muna siya muna ang pamukaunon. Ikatu, throwing banana peel on the ground. Ubus kimaun saing in batabatayaon, biugit na paisaing. Hati niya, magbugit paisaing halantay. Marayaw ba yan o mangi? Okay. Next picture, buying street foods without cover. Magbi makaunharan, wairuun saub or wailukub niya. Pagkaw, marayaw ba yan? Okay, aw niyan waktu in langaw maglupad-lupad na doon. Okay, next, cleaning the street, maglano sindan at wala lalabayan sin kita, lanuan. Okay. And last, combing the hair. Magsuklay buhok. Okay, so how nurunin mga kakahinang ikarayaw sinbaran na to? Okay, so naubos na kamo nag-answer. Okay, so marikita nyo pa sa dia kamo pa lesson 5. Okay, marayaw in pangajian din di makakatud kita pangajian marayaw. So in topic niya ri, what are you waiting for? Hati niya, uno pa in tagaran mo. So in title niya, the ants. Okay, so basahon ko dungog kamo marayaw. One day, a lazy man saw 100 of ants. Each ant carries food. Hati niya, in ants yaon mga tausog, in sanam. Okay, nakita na kamo sanam. Okay. Hambok adlaw, nakita in usog, lisuan. Yatusan sanam. Tiap-tiap hambok din kanila nagdara kakaon. So they are helping each other in carrying big food. Finally, they carried the food into the hall. So magtulong tabang in pakanya-kanya hapagdasing kakaon malago. In tubtuban, naranila in pagkaon palomsin lungag. Okay, so aun pa nga subo. What is the moral lesson in the story? So, unuin makawa pangadian hakisa sinsanam. Okay. Very good. Atin niya in mga sanam ini, in sila ini, matibot, iwan matuyo. No? Iwan, in sila magtabang-tiabangi. Magtabang-tabang sila, di sila magpasad. Okay, so biyaturay sab in pangadatan sin kita marayaw, subay magtabang-tabang, iwan, di sila magpikil sin luog nila. So hard, they work hard. Okay, so that they can reap the benefits tomorrow. So magtaw sila pagkaon nila, supaya hasusungon, aun makawa mahampit nila. Okay. So, in virtues of hard work and planning for the future. So, in moral lesson, amuyatin makata. So, aun sila, pagtabang-tabang, iban, matibot sila. Okay. So, mari kita pa, let's practice. Okay, answeran nyo isab ini. Okay, I will read the directions. Okay, complete each sentence. Underline the correct word inside the parenthesis. Okay, hati niya, jukupa in kaptangan, good listen, in bunal halomsin, baugan. Okay, basahon ko, underline na nyo sadya, in pagpian nyo dua word. Okay, one day, a lazy lad, man sat under the tree. He saw hundreds of rats or ants. They were all organized and running, moving. Each ant carries food, stone. They are helping, stepping each other in carrying big food. Finally, they carried the food into the mall hall. Okay, so tausog niya, hambok adlaw in lisuan, subol. Magpika mo in answer, lisuan ka or subol. Usog. Naglilingkod hasom kahoy. Nakita siya giyatusan mga ambaw atawa sanam. So, unin answer niyo. Ambaw yung kita niya or sanam? In sila katan, nagtutukot yukuhi. Iban, dimaragan, himihibal. Unagunin sanam, dimaragan or himihibal. Okay, pagpian yung answer yan. So, tiap-tiap sanam, nagdara, kakaun, bato. Hey, unin di arasin sanam, kakaon ataw bato. So, in sila, nagtulong, tabang, nagmamahil. Okay, hapagdas, impagkaon, maaslag. Ha, kahinapusan, naranila, impagkaon, palaom, lungag, or taylalat. Okay, so, pinakamuang jawab niyo. Okay, so, basta huntay niya supaya di takalupahan. As a Muslim, we have to affirm the ashhadatain. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. I bear witness that there is no God except Allah. Washhadu anna Muhammad Muhammad is his messenger. In Muslim, subay siya mga hagad hadua saksi. Magsaksi ako inway Tuhan mapatut pagtag-ipunan malengkan Allah. Iban magsaksi ako in Muhammad daaksin Allah. So we should apply the values of cleanliness and personal hygiene. Subay tahinangun in pangadatan marayaw biya nasin maglano ibansin pagsusi sin ginhawabaran. Okay, we have to be hard working like the ants. Subay kita matibut biya sin sanam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ar-Razzaq, the everlasting sustainer. In Allah, siya in magdidirijiki, di magbugtuin, dirihilan niya. Okay, so let's see how much you have learned today. Kita unta kuno bang hariin na in kiyahatihan yung adlaw ini. So jawaban niyo in mga pangasubo ha-assessment. Okay, so direction number one, the following steps of wudu are not in the correct number or order, which should come first. So number them from 1 to 11. Write the number inside the small box. So wala na susun-susun in aturan sin pag-ayil, pag-sunua. Umbuli day na hambuok pahangpo tag-isa. Sulatan in umbul halom sin tuong. So amuna yan in mga steps sin wudu, butangan nyo siya number 1 hang up to pa 11. Okay, so hikaruwa exercise niyo, name each part of the picture, then color it. So, aun din dun araw, timudlo, ha mga patta yan. So, ngani injinisan sin patta, pagubos ang pamu warna e. Why na bida warna in hibutang mo? Okay. So, dito na, timubtub, impangadjian ta. Alhamdulillah, mura-murahan, makakamu pangadjian, din kamu adlaw ini. Wabillahi taufik wal hidayah, this is Teacher Jahara saying, wa ilalika, walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillah. Assalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Wa ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Marayawat law kan yung katan dimurungog ha programa na to. Di hakasusuban na to a registration D-XXX. Hadlaw ini, yari na isab, ika niyo tuwanta ha?
Bani, teacher niyo dayang.
Nagbalik ha, para hapangadjian na to, impangadjian na to hadlaw ini, amunain, pagtaat parwa maas. Halialihanta niyo na ahang karay, para hapatumtum ini. Stay tuned.
أشرقت نفسي بنور من فؤادي حينما رددت يا رب العباد وانتشت روحي وصار الدمع يجري يا إله.
الحمد لله يا ريني سبك منك بلي إبان سينك مويان دمس مسي دمرونغوغ kaputin niyo, iwan ukaban niyo, encapsulate niyo, magdungan-dungan tanyo, basahon, suy-suy ini.
It was Saturday morning. Fatima and Ummi are very busy cleaning their house and backyard. This is a time for helping their parents. Omar is busy reading his book. His father said, "My son, please help Ummi clean our backyard." Omar replied, "Abi, I still have many things to study. Our ustad assigned me to read my kitab." His father said, "But today is Saturday. You still have time to do your assignment. Didn't your ustad teach you about obedience to parents? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards those who obey their parents. Omar answered, "Sorry, Abi. Yes, our ustads taught us to obey our parents. Allah ta'ala favors children who are obedient to their parents. I will just fix my things, then I will help Umi clean the backyard. Thank you, my son," his father replied. "He will go to mall with Fatima and Umi after you're done cleaning."
May laatin adlaw sabto, naglanubay iban halaman ni Fatima kaina niya. Amin waktu tumabang hamaas niya. Nagbawas sa kitab hi Umar. Agi hi ama niya, uto, tabangi hi ina mo maglano halaman hatay kudbay. Insambong hi Umar kanama niya, "Ama, yari pa ako nangangadji. Aun kitab, piyabas sa kamu sinustaz na mo." Agisin ama, at law ini sabto. Aun pawaktu mo huminang sinhinang tuon kay mo. Mahi, wala kau hinduan sinustaz. Tungod, pagta at pamaas, gandahan sin Allahu Ta'ala, bang hisisyo imagta at parwa maas niya. Sambung hi Omar, "Maaf ama, hinduan kami sinustaz na mo, magtaat pamaas. Kaulungan kau sinallahu ta'ala. Inbata nagtaat pamaas niya, mumusun ko sadya im mga kitab ko. Ampa ako madto, tumabangkan ina maglano sin halaman hatay ko. Magsukol anak," sambung sin ama niya kanya. "Madto kita niyo patinda hi Fatima iban hi ina mo pag-uhos niyo maglano."
Halialihan tanyo na hangkaray, ayaw ko mag-ig, di high station tanyo, di triple X, magbalik da kami, stay tuned. Alhamdulillah, yari na isab kita nung nagbalik, damikyaning kamu masimasi, dimurungog, ha programa tanyo. Bihaon lumatun kita nyo pa self-assessment question. Number 1.
What is obedience?
Uno, inhati simpagtaat. Number 2.
What are the deeds showing obedience to parents?
Uno naman in hinang marayaw, hipagmarayaw ta parwa maasta. Tumtumun taniyo, ayaw taniyo kalupahan. Bunal tuo din Allahu Ta'ala, tungbasan niya in bata atawa anak, nagtaat parwa maas niya. Pasal impagtaat parwa maas, lawang papagtaat pa Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Hangkan, suway tanyo di pahil-pahilun, impagtaat ataw pagmarayaw tanyo, parwa maas tanyo. Sabab, bang kita nyo nagmarayaw parwa maas, biada kita nakapagmarayaw, fa Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Hangkan na imbata, suway siya mapanday, pakuyahun niya indwa maas niya, hasupaya in Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala kumuyag kaniya. Sabab, in kuyag sin Allahu Ta'ala, doon tanyo kabakan hakuyag sin duamaas tanyo. Iban imbungsi atawa astul sin Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, doon tanyo kabakan habungsi iban astul sin duamaas tanyo. Bihaon sulayan tanyo, bang uno inna kawa taniu pangadjian ha adlaw ini. Hatungud simpag taat parwa maas. Kawa kamu katas niu iwan simpensil niu. Sulatan niu hakatas niu bunnal bang ingkap tangan ini imamu. Sulatan niu hakatas niu bukun bang ingkap tangan ini wala imamu. Number one.
Obedience to parents is a way of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Impagtaat pamaas lawang siapa pagtaat pa Allahu subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two.
A child should follow all orders of his her parents.
In bata suway magad hapamintoro si maas niya. Number three.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards a child for obeying his her parents.
Tungbasan sin Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in bata nagtataat pamaas. Number four.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punishes a child for not obeying his her parents.
Siksaun sin Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in bata di magtaat pamaas. Number five.
Obey your parents next to your friends.
Magtaat na pamaas ampa pakabagayan. Mahuli, mamaid na kami kaniyo. Ini hika ni tuantaha iban.
Teacher Dayang.
Habaliwasan Central School, Sped Center, MEP Teacher, COS. Salam kasila sa kaniyo katan. Wa ilal lika.
Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.
Suena, balance, mapuersa. Este el RPND Triple X, Radio Ronda Zamboanga.
Solid for news and information. Public service and entertainment. This is D Triple X, 108 kHz in Zamboanga.
Magandang araw mga mami at daddy. Alam niyo ba na patuloy ang banta ng tigdas? Ang tigdas ay posibleng magdudulot ng kapansanan o pagkamatay kapag hindi naagapan. Bakuna ang tanging solusyon. Pabakunahan ang inyong mga anak na wala pang 5 taong gulang ng dagdag bakuna kontra rubella at tigdas. Simula ngayong 26 ng Oktubre hanggang 25 ng Nobyembre. Sa bakuna